Hello YouTube, my name is Nir, and today there were a few magazine covers and details revealed about the Last Jedi movie, so today I'm going to cover my thoughts on them. So let's get started with the magazine covers. First off, we have Poe, Finn, BB-8, and a new character named Rose, which is said to be a mechanic in the Resistance, which gets into a little affair with Finn, so... what is that gonna mean? Romance? Just friendship? Just like Lando kind of friendship? Which, yeah, that does not end up well. Please don't be a retread of Empire of the Last Jedi. I beg you. So yeah, this cover looks really nice. My second least favorite though, I mean, it's not because it's bad or anything. There are just a few others I like more. But it looks really cool. The background looks gray. So, yeah, I guess it looks nice. Next up, we just have Leia. May Carrie Fisher rest in peace. So, she has a bit of different robes. It really shows, like, I don't know, she looks much more senator-like. So, what's up with that? I thought that Disney don't like the prequels, but I don't really care about that. So, it looks nice. Nothing much to say except for it's Leia with new clothes. And now my second favorite image out of those, we have Luke and Rey. Now they really look like a master and apprentice. I like that. Their clothes look really similar, and the only difference between their clothes and it's almost the same clothes that we saw in the finale of The Force Awakens, except for one difference. Luke has a glove. Well, I don't really like that. I prefer him just having the robotic arm. You just see that he has a robot hand, but yeah, I guess it's good. It's nice too. The background is clearly Octo, which is the planet where Rey found Luke. Overall, this looks really cool. Nothing much to say. It barely reveals anything. And the next one, which is my favorite out of all the magazine covers, we have Kylo Ren, General Hux, and Captain Phasma. All new designs, sort of. Let's get into that. So, least changed is Hux. The only change he has is a new haircut looking thing. Looks different, but I don't really mind that. I'm just glad to see that he'll be in The Last Jedi. Let's move on to Kylo Ren. He looks really similar to what he looked like in The Force Awakens, only he has a scar which has strangely moved. Well, I guess it's okay. And his unstable crossguard lightsaber is back in episode 8. Yes! I love that lightsaber. And what else there is? I mean, he has a cape. So, what, you're trying to be more like your granddaddy, Kylo? Is that it? I mean, it looks really cool with that cape. So, I don't know. Looks nice. And his robes look a bit different, like... looks the same, only looks like different fabric. I don't know how to explain that, but overall it's pretty much the same. And now the most interesting of them all, Captain Phasma without her helmet. So first of all, yes, that means he's gonna be a main character in The Last Jedi. Thank you, I really need some redeeming after Force Awakens where she was literally thrown in the garbage. Anyway, she looks like she's having some sort of staff, which looks awesome, except for that, really, nothing. I mean, she does still have her old, her armor from The Force Awakens. Great, it survived the trash compactor. So, why is her helmet off? Well, in the Last Jedi teaser, we clearly see her helmet is on. So, what's up with that? I don't know, maybe it gets scratched, who knows? I don't know, I'm just really excited to see her in The Last Jedi. Hope you guys are too. And yeah, that was the magazine covers. Now let's move on to other images and more news. So we have a few images of the new city known as Canto Bite, which is hopefully not gonna be Cloud City 2.0. Please don't make that. So the crowd looks nice, I like it. And then we have a few menacing shots of Kylo Ren, actually only one, and another really nice looking shot of Rey without her blue jacket. They both look awesome. I might personally prefer Kylo. Well, it's because I love villains better. Don't judge me. Don't hate me. I still love Luke Skywalker. I still love Rey. I still love everybody else. Like Han Solo. Just prefer the bad guys. So yeah, those images look really nice. And the second I saw this image, I just had a big within my heart. Just seeing those two reunite, Luke and Leia. I just really hope that's not just a picture from the set and a scene that it will actually feature in the film. Please, I really want to see them reunite. Unless you're not gonna kill off Luke, right, Disney? Right? Right? Don't kill off Luke. And as far as I know, that's really it. If I forgot anything or if there is anything else, please let me know in the comments. I really wanna know more about The Last Jedi, but not everything. I still wanna see the mystery alive until I sit in the theater. So there is also rumored to be an official trailer near the end of the summer. I can't wait for that. If it's true, it's not confirmed as far as I know. It's a rumor, which I hope is true, because I really want to see another trailer. Oh yeah, and I forgot, there is another image of Benicio del Toro's character. I hope I pronounced his name right. So he's not gonna be a Sith or a bad guy or anything else. So people made out those theories, stop it. He's apparently some sort of junker or scavenger or whatever called DJ, I think. DJ? Is that it? Well, yeah, I have nothing to say about that. I really thought it was gonna be some sort of dark side force using villain. And we have nothing about Snoke. Absolutely nothing. Okay, I mean, the new Emperor, okay, I guess we don't need much of him. I just want to see a new shot of him. I want to learn more about this guy. Is he 9 million feet tall like we saw in Force Awakens? Well, actually, no, he's confirmed to be 7 feet tall, I think. 7 feet, not sure. But don't worry, he's not some giant. So, yeah, that was it for today. I have no idea how long this video was. Sorry if it's a bit too long. I'll see you next time, and goodbye.